Okay, discrete time. Discrete time signals and system. Okay, by definition, by definition, discrete is for digital lah. Discrete time signals is defined as a function of a discrete time instant that is defined by integer n. Okay. Sample signal which used by digital computer is discrete time signals. For example, kalau continuous is analog, discrete is for digital. Similarity of both signal are expressed mostly by time or space, but for T for continuous, T for continuous time signal, N for discrete time signal, N is integer. Integer means that N equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on lah. And so on, which means that N is the sample, sample size, sample data. But it is represented by time, but the time is now replaced by N value, data samples. And both, whether it is in continuous time signal or discrete time signal, both are classified as periodic and non-periodic. What is periodic? What is non-periodic? Okay, this is the comparison. For continuous time signal, the continuous time signal is continuous lah from XT to T. Okay, but for discrete time signal, it is now indiscrete. This is a discrete value. It has a sample value. For example, here we have Xn. This is n equals to 0. Yeah, n equals to 0. For n equals to 0, let's say lah, the value here is 1. The value of the for x xn and xn, xn, okay, maybe it is 1. Okay, now for n equals to 0, xn is 1. For n equals to 1, the value is 0.7, for example, 0.7. And then n equals to 2, the value is 0. And then n equals to 3, the value is negative 0.7. And so on. So as n ni dia adalah integer, n is an integer value, which means that the value is from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. And no floating point value. No point value macam 1.1 ke, 1.2 ke, 1.3 ke, dia tak ada. It just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Okay, berbeza macam continuous time signal. You can cater a signal in T kan? 1.1 contohnya. You can cater the signal in 0.5. T equals to 0.5. So you still get the value here. At T equals to 0.5, you still have some values. But here, for N equals to 0.5, there's no value at N equals to 0.5 because it is discrete. So discrete, they just ambil point by point je. Okay, faham eh? Okay. discrete time signal is periodic if it has the signal from negative infinite to positive infinite. Okay, from negative infinite to positive infinite, the value is the same. Maksudnya dia pattern dia sama je. Then it is a periodic signal. Contoh, given the signal below, ni bukan contoh periodic signal. This is example of discrete time signal lah, not a periodic signal. Okay, xn equals to 2, n for n equals to 2, n 4. And then negative 1, n, 1, 1, 3, 7, 0 elsewhere. Draw the signal in time. So how to draw the signal in time? So we know that for n 2 dengan 4 ni, okay. Ni 0 ya, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Equals to 2, equals to 2, at n equals to 2 and 4, and equals to negative 1 for n, 1, 3, ni bukanlah ni. 7. Ini salah ni. Kalau kita refer pada the solution, then we notice that okay, n equals to 2, 4 and 7 for as n equals to 2. And then it is equal, as n is negative 1, for n equals to 1 and 3. And it is 0 elsewhere. Okay. Next. Types of non-periodic signal. First, we have delta function or impulse function. Delta function ataupun impulse function is a function that exists only when n equals to 0. Impulse, yeah? it is an impulse. Impulse means that when we turn on some switch, then it has some impulse there. So other than n equals to 0, the function will not exist. So as n, impulse function ni, dia punya simbol dia adalah delta n. So whenever you found delta n, it is always looks like this one lah. Fungsi dia, the function is as n equals to 1, n equals to 0. Okay, ni eh, macam ni eh. A function that exists only when n equals to 0. Maksudnya dia cuma ada satu je dekat sini. But you need to consider jugalah if there are some delay delta n minus 1. So dia punya function ni dia exist dekat sini lah. Dekat sini. 1. This is for delta n minus 1. Okay, yang ini adalah delta n. Ini adalah delta n. Okay, so untuk delta function ni ada tiga yang you kena, you need to notice eh. If delta n, the response is like this. Kosong. Okay. If delta n minus 1, the response is at n equals to 1. So let's say this is xn. Eh? This is xn. So response dia appear at n equals to 1. Okay, if delta n plus 1, then the response is appeared at negative 1. This one is delta n. Delta n ataupun xn lah input dia, xn. So delta n plus 1 dia dekat bahagian negatif lah. Ada tiga lah dekat situ. If n tu dia ada time shifting ya. Eh? Okay, second is step function. If delta function is it only one impulse. Step function, a function that exists only when n greater than 0. Other time, the function will not exist. So this is step function. Yeah, ni step function eh. Sorry, step function ni macam ni lah. Step function. UN eh. And then, pulse rectangular function, unit pulse function is like this eh. It is identified from n0 to n1. Certain values lah dekat sini. Okay. Ramp function. Okay, this is ramp function. Ramp function is xn equals to n. Symbol dia rn lah. And then pulse sinusoid. Pulse sinusoid ni, it is a pulse function, pulse with sinusoid function inside. So it is identified as cos 2 pi f1n minus theta for n greater than 0 and equals to 0 elsewhere. So you have pulse sinusoid lah kat sini. Ataupun it may be defined in, ni bukan. It is from certain value eh. N0 to N1. So kita adalah N0 sampai N1 dekat sini. Other than that is 0. Okay, next is system ya. Yeah? System operates with an input signal and output as a result. So dia sama juga macam continuous time, but now it replaced by N lah, discrete ya. Eh? Discrete, semua discrete, indiscrete. Okay, characteristic, kita ada time invariant juga. A system is time invariant if the output of a system if the output of the system does not depend on time, the system is said to be time invariant. Maksudnya if the output, if the input is delayed with, if the input time is delayed, then the output will also be delayed with the same amount. Shift invariant, if the input is apa tu shifted tu maksudnya dia ada phase, eh? Dia shift by some phase tu sudnilah apa tu apa ya, phase tu adalah some theta, phase kan some amount, some theta value, then the output will also follow with the same amount. Also shifted by the same amount. Causality, if system is causal, if it is only depends on past and current input, but not future input. Maksudnya dia cuma dekat bahagian responder cuma ada dekat bahagian sini je. Dekat bahagian sini dia tak ada. Positive value. Past and current. Stability, if you can sum up the value, semua value yang ada ni, kalau kita boleh hasil campurkan dia, then dia adalah a stable system. But if it is reached infinite value, maksudnya dia sentiasa ada respon sampai infinity, then the system is not stable. Linearity, the system is linear if it has the superposition and scaling properties. Maksudnya kalau kita scaling the input, the output will be also scaling alpha x1n. Output pun kita akan dapat alpha y1n. Ataupun kalau kita tambahkan x1n plus x2n, output will be also the same as you get y1n plus y2n, or whether you do the addition ni, kita buat secara berasingan, we separate or we mix up together, it will still get the same amount of value. So it is a linear lah, linearity system lah, linear system lah, we call it as linear system. So yang kita nak fokus adalah linear time invariant system. The system supposed to be linear and time invariant. Linear time invariant system. Okay, discrete time system, ya. An operator or transform which maps into xn to yn. Delay, accumulator. Accumulator ni yang ni. Pengumpul. Dia ada memory. Salah. Kat sini dia ada memory, kat sini accumulator. Okay. Properties of linear time invariant system. We have some commutative, cascade, associative, ini semua macam mana cara ni lah, apa tu, system lah, system punya properties. Determine whether the following system is causal or not. So how to determine whether a system is causal or not? Siapa boleh bagi jawapan? Okay, causal system is always apa? Always depends on the current and past, and past time. So whenever you apa tu? So yang bahagian sini ni yang negatif lah. Shifted dia negatif, yang bahagian sini shifted dia positif. So kalau awak jumpa je tanda plus dekat sini, so dia terus jadi non-causal. Ingat tu je. Kalau ada plus, kalau if it is minus, then okay. Okay, if minus then okay lah. Causal, whether it is xn minus 1 ataupun yn minus 1, then okay. Okay, next is convolution. Convolution is the operation of any two function. It's similar like apa tu, continuous time signal and system tadi. You just replace T kepada N, ya. So dia akan jadi lebih mudah. If in continuous time signal, it is an integral function between H lambda and X N minus lambda. But for discrete time, It is a sum up. Hasil tambah. Hasil tambah tu macam mana? Okay. Jom kita tengok contoh ni. Linear time invariant system is the... Okay, let's say we have a system Hn equals to 1 for n from 0 to 3. Okay, so if we draw... Yeah. 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so this is Hn. And then the input is given as Sn equals to 1 for n from 0 to 1. So input kita n equals to 1 untuk 0 dan 1 sahaja. Xn. Ni saya tak tulis value amplitude dia sama dengan 1 eh. Ni samalah. Ha, ni pun samalah juga. So what is the output of the system? Ha, so the output is the same like continuous time signal where first you need to change Hn become H lambda. Okay. Apa yang kita kena buat dekat sini? First kali tukar Hn jadi H lambda. So, dia sama juga. Cuma, tapi kita ikut kita follow formula ni eh. X lambda, Hn minus lambda. So, you need to change Hn. Okay, first kali Hn become H lambda. So, it is still the same lah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tapi kat sini jadi lambda. Okay, Sn akan jadi X lambda. So, it's still the same lah. Cuma, dia jadi lambda dekat sini. 1, 2. So, 0, 1. 0, 1, 2, 3. And then, next, change H lambda jadi H negatif lambda. So, H negatif lambda adalah... Okay. And then, third step. Mana ni? Oh. H negatif lambda eh. H negatif lambda dia akan jadi at the negative side lah. So kalau tadi dekat macam ni. So sekarang H negatif lambda kita ada daripada 0, negatif 1, negatif 2, negatif 3. Okay, value dia samalah 1 juga. Cuma dia dekat, ni value dia sama cuma dia dekat bahagian negatif. Ni H ya, dia saya flipkan H. Saya tak flip X, saya flipkan H. Okay, so what happen next? So kita dah nampak, inilah bila kita flip dia jadi macam ni. Bila kita flip, ni after flip eh. After flip. So X lambda dia kekal lah. X lambda kita tak flip. X lambda kita tak flip, kita only flip H negatif lambda sahaja. So then baru kita compute the overlap value. Yang mana yang overlap? Kat sini. Ada satu je kan? So ada satu sama dengan satu lah. Sebab amplitude dia kan satu. Amplitude dia satu. Ni semua satu ya amplitude dia. Okay. So first kali Yn sama dengan satu. Ni untuk result dia untuk Y0 lah. Y0 sama dengan 1. And then Y2 sama dengan 2. Untuk Y2, untuk Y0, Y2 pula. Y1, sorry. Y1 ni. Y1 sama dengan, Y1 sama dengan 2. Sebab bila kita move, and then kita move kan? Kita gerakkan dia ke kanan kan? Then kita tengok ada berapa yang overlap. Ada 2 yang overlap. So 1 campur 1 sama dengan 1 campur 1 sama dengan 2. So kita dapat Y1 sama dengan 2. And then kita move lagi. Kita move lagi nampak ni eh. Kesan move dia kat sini eh. Okay, kita tengok ni. Tadi kita move kat sini, kita move 1 je. Ni kan? Move 1 kan? Move 1 step. Then next we move again, we move. Then, kita dah movekan kat sini lah. Dia dah berganjak sebanyak 2. And then, kita kira yang overlap, kita dapat 1 campur 1 sama dengan 2. Next, again, kita move lagi. Kita move lagi. Then, yang overlap pun sama dengan 2. Move lagi. Kali ni dah 4 dah ya. Kita dah 4 dah ni. Kita dah shiftkan dia 4. So, kita dapat 1. Ada 1 je yang overlap. And then, kalau kita move lagi, tak ada dah. Dah tak ada yang overlap. So, kosong lah. So, overall result will be macam ni lah. Tadi kita dapat Y kosong. Tadi kita dapat result kita Y kosong sama dengan 1. Y1 sama dengan 2. Y2 sama dengan 2. Y3 sama dengan 2. Y4 sama dengan 1. Y5 sama dengan 0. So this is the overall. The overall, the result will be like this. So senang je kan? Convolution? Okay, this is another example. Given the system and power response as Hn and the input Xn is as below lah. Hn equals to 1 and from 0 to 2 and equals to 0 elsewhere. So if we draw our system, Hn is satu, dua, tiga. Kosong, satu, dua. Sama dengan satu. Yang lain dia kosong. Sn is, okay. Kalau yang tadi kita bagi dalam bentuk math punya ni kan. Kita, kalau yang ini, kita terus direct bagi. Input Sn sama dengan satu. N from 0 to 1. Tapi berbeza yang ini, saya bagi dalam bentuk delta function. So, macam mana nak lukis? Macam mana you nak sketch the signal ni? So you need to know how to sketch if delta n dekat mana delta n? It's n. Where? It's supposed to be the impulse rate function. Kat sini kan? So this is delta n. And then delta n minus 4? Delta n minus 4 dekat mana? Dekat n sama dengan 4 eh. Dekat di sini 4. Dekat n sama dengan 4, amplitude dia adalah negatif 1 per 2. Negatif 1 per 2. Yang ni 1. So awak kena tahu macam mana nak draw. Nak sketch signal tu. Okay, oh, soalan dia is this system linear? Please explain the reasons. Untuk soalan ni, is the system linear? Please explain the reason. This question, saya jadikan soalan ni sebagai quiz satu awak. Please respond. Please provide the answer. Paling lewat hari Rabu ni. Boleh ya? Hari Rabu sebelum jam 5 petang. Nanti saya akan buka dalam ULearn lah. This is your first quiz. So macam bonus jugalah. Okay? Setuju tak?
Setuju madam. Okey je.
Okey, okey je. Memanglah sepatutnya kena okey lah. Okey, linear convolution ya. Next example, given two signal as input and system, impulse response as below. Xn equals to 1, 1 over 2, 1 over 4, 0, 0. Hn equals to 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Determine the linear convolution output Yn of this signal. So this one, ada lagi satu cara untuk buat convolution. Kalau tadi graphical method kan? Kalau graphical method, yang inilah. Maksudnya awak lukis dulu, sketch the graph and then shift to the right. Sampailah dia habis overlap kan? Satu lagi cara adalah dengan menggunakan table. Buat table. So kalau saya lagi suka cara ni. Sebab clear tau guna cara ni. Okay. So how to use table to compute convolution? First sekali, you have Xn and Hn. So Xn awak duduk dekat sini. XN XN HN HN dekat sini. Ni maksudnya bukanlah macam ni. Maksudnya kat sini. Sorry. Ini HN. Ini HN kita 11100. Okey, 11100. Okey, 11100. Dia start dengan 0 kat sini. Dia start dengan 0. Lepas tu X kita 1 1/2 1/4 0 0. So kita flip kan. Kita negatifkan dulu. 1 1/2 1/4 0 0. Nampak tak? Ini untuk ni lah. Ini untuk yang first step. Untuk first step kita negatifkan input dia, so dia akan duduk dekat bahagian negatif. Kita flipkan dia. Ini n kan? Atas ni n. First row adalah n, n time dia. Second row adalah h, and then the third row ni adalah input kita. So kita tengok yang kat mana yang overlap. Macam ini 1 kali 1 kita dapat 1 lah. So kita dapat 1. And then next we shift to the right. Nampak tak? Kita dah shifted the input to the right, and then compute the region that is overlap. So 1 × 1/2 kita dapat 1/2, 1 × 1 dapat 1. So kita tambahkan 1 × 1/2 kita dapat 3/2. Next, shift lagi to the right. So kita nampak sini kan dia dah bergerak lagi ke kanan. Then bila kita campur, kita campurkan first unit to multiply dululah. 1 × 1/4 is 1/4. 1 × 1/2 dapat 1/2. 1 × 1 dapat 1. Then when we mix, up the value is 7/4. Okay, and then kiralah sampai habis. Sampai dah tak ada overlap lagi. Kat sini dah tak overlap kan? So kita dapat kosong dekat sini. Okay, so the output is now equals to 1. Ini untuk n sama dengan 0. And then 3/2 untuk n equals to 1. 7/4 untuk x untuk n equals to 2. And then until ni lah, until finish lah. So kita dapat result ni. Yn equals to this value lah. And you can plot it. You can sketch the graph lah from here. Okay, next is circular convolution. Circular convolution is done for a periodic for a periodic signal. Kalau linear convolution is only can be done for a non-periodic signal. Maksudnya signal tu dia ada start point dengan end point dia. Dia limited. Dia macam dia ada apa tu? Sequence dia ada 5 je, ada 7 je, macam tu. But if there are the signal is the signal is periodic, maksudnya from negative to positive, from infinite, it has infinite value, then we need to apply circular convolution. Tu je beza dia. Circular convolution tu macam mana? Ini example of linear convolution. This is linear convolution. Ya, ni linear convolution ke circular? Okay, kalau circular convolution maksudnya signal ni dia periodic. So dia ada lagi. Bila dah sampai sini dia ada lagi 1, 1/2, 1/4, and it always periodic lah with the same amount. So kat sini contoh dia. Maksudnya ini dia masih lagi continue. So the result will be also ni lah. Dia akan terus compute lah result tu. Kat sini ni dia tak sepatutnya kena duplicate value. The same value kat sini ni dia duplicated. Ni kena ada 1, 1/2, 1/4. So this is how we compute the circular convolution. dia akan berulang. Nampak kan? Sini dia akan, bila dia habis satu round, dia ada lagi. Another round. Okay. And then, how to get the same result for circular convolution, because circular convolution is for periodic signal, but to have the, to get the same result as a linear convolution, we need to put zero padding. Zero padding tu maksudnya kita tambah kosong pada signal tu. Zero padding is utilized to ensure that the circular convolution is equal to linear convolution and it is equal to both length of the signal plus one. Maksudnya kita ada signal tadi, length of xn plus length of hn, kita tambah satu. So kita dapat zero padding tu, kita tambah kosong. Kita tambah kosong dekat signal tu sebanyak di sequence. Sebanyak length of xn plus length of hn plus one. Okay, dah habis.